Hello and welcome to PDFSupply.com. Today we're going to be testing a 9030 processor, a CPU360. So I have here specifically part number IC693CPU360, and I'm going to be attaching it to an IC693CHS397 5-slot rack, which is empty. For the purpose of this test, we're just going to be testing the processor alone. And it's going to be powered by our high-capacity power supply. This is an IC693PWR330. So the first thing I'm going to do is power it up. And I want to look for a solid OK LED light. So the power's on, OK is on. This tells me that the processor is in good working condition so far. If this light is not on, then it's very likely you have a problem with your processor. Or if it's blinking, you probably have a problem with your processor. And this is something that we typically look at here at PDF Supply. We do repairs, we offer exchange programs, new and remanufactured products. So if that's something we can help you with, please see us at pdfsupply.com. So what I'm going to do now is connect up to the processor. I also want to indicate that I have the memory protect in the off position. I recommend that you do that, and I'll explain why in a moment. And I'm going to look in the main rack. I'm in Prophecy Machine Edition. I'm going to look in the main rack. And what I'm looking for here is to make sure that slots numbers 2 through 5 are empty and that slot number 1 has a CPU360 in it, which I do. And then I'm ready to download and run this simple configuration. Before I do, I'm going to go to Target, Online Commands, and go to Clear. What I'm clearing here, when you open up the submenu, Clear Memory, you just want to select the bottom two categories, which is Controller Fault Table and I/O Fault Table. And clear that. Don't clear any memory or anything like that, because there may be information on the processor you want to protect. So I'm going to go ahead and download and run this blank configuration. Download and run. So the goal here is that I want to get the processor into run mode. It's an indication to us that the processor is a good working processor if it's able to go into run mode. Now it's asking me, what do I want to download to the controller? In this case, hardware configuration and logic. Just the top two, nothing else, and I don't want to write anything to flash memory, so just hardware and logic. Okay, now, I haven't gone into run mode yet, and the reason is because I want to test that the memory protect switch is working, which is also an I/O enable switch. This does two functions. So the error I'm getting here says the controller is not in run mode after you attempted to start it. This may be due to a run-stop position application. That's true. So when I turn this in on, I'm looking for the I/O to be enabled or the processor to be in run mode. Okay, so know that this works. This is the only button feature that I can test on this processor. So pretty much the test is complete as far as getting the processor in a run mode, make sure it's able to get in run mode. So if this is a processor that you've found us because you feel like you may have a problem with it, what I would recommend is running the processor overnight or over a weekend, a couple days, 3 days. And what you're doing there is you're trying to make sure that the processor actually can hold itself in run mode, that it stays in run mode for that period of time. That's typically the second part of our test if we feel like there's a problem. So if it kicks itself out of run mode, what we would recommend doing is going into your Prophecy Machine Edition to Target. And the subcategory is Diagnostics. And when you click on Diagnostics, your Info Viewer tab will open up with a fault table, and it'll tell you exactly what faulted, why it got kicked out of run mode. Some of these explanations aren't really very understandable. So if it's something that's troubling you and you can't figure it out and the fault table isn't any help, this is something that we repair quite frequently here. And again, we offer exchange programs and new and remanufactured products if that helps you. So please see us at pdfsupply.com. Thank you.